Yes, last paragraph. She went home and she pinned her drawing over a torn place in the pink flowered wallpaper in the bedroom. Now in Maddie's home, there was a pink flowered wallpaper and there was a torn place. In that particular place, she pinned her drawing. The shabby room came alive. From the brilliancy of the colors. The colors which Wanda has used, that colors are very bright colors she had used. And with that color, that room which was looking very shabby, suddenly after hanging that picture, the room was looking very alive. It happens sometime if some room is very dull or shabby, if we decorate any of the corner with pictures or with any other drawing or any wall hanging, definitely that color, that room looks alive. So the same thing happened with Maddie. Maddie sat down on her bed and looked at the drawing. Now Maddie was looking continuously. She sat on the bed and she was looking at the drawing. She had stood by and said nothing. Now she stood by and said nothing. But Wanda had been nice to her anyway. And what she was thinking, whatever they had done, she know. Maybe she haven't said any word to Wanda, but she had supported Peggy. So after that also, Wanda know whatever they had done was not good. But she is good with them. She is nice with them. Whatever is over, but she is nice with them. The next page. Tears blurred. Tears blurred her eyes and she gazed for a long time at the picture. Now what happened? Tears blurred. Whenever tears come in your eyes, definitely you are not able to see properly. So tear blurred her eyes. And she gazed for a long time at the picture. Now gazed, looking, look fixed at a particular thing. So she gazed for a long time at the picture. Then hastily she rubbed her eyes and studied it intently. Then hastily she rubbed, hastily, very fast, she rubbed her eyes and studied it intently. Intently means keenly. Now she want to observe very keenly that drawing. The colors in the dress were so vivid. Vivid means clear. The color she had used in that dress are very clear, that she had scarcely noticed the face and head of the drawing. Now she haven't, when earlier she had seen the drawing, but she had not seen very keenly. Now when you observe anything very keenly, what happened that time, you are able to come to know very minute points also. So minutely she observed and she came to know that she is able to see a head, a face on that drawing. But it looked like her, Maddie. It really looked like her own mouth. And she came to know that the face is looking same like her. Why it really looked like her own self? Wanda had really drawn this for her? Excitedly, she ran over to Peggy's. Now she had seen, oh, Wanda has made my face in this drawing. This is looking like me, same like me. Wanda had really drawn this for her. That means from the earlier also, Wanda has imagined my face. And this drawing she made for me. Excitedly, she ran over to Peggy. Now, excitedly, she ran over to Peggy's. Peg, she said, let me see your picture. What's the matter? Asked Peggy. As they cluttered up to her room, where Wanda's drawing was lying face down on the bed. Now, she said, Peg, let me see your picture. I want to see your picture. What is the matter? Asked Peggy. Peggy said, what is the matter? Why you want to look at my picture? As they cluttered means walked up to her room where Wanda's drawing was lying face down on the bed. The drawing was lying face down on the bed. Maddie carefully raised it. Look, she drew you. And now she told, look, she drew your face. That's you, she exclaimed. And then the head and face of the picture did look like Peggy. What did I say? Said Peggy. She must have. She'd really like us anyway. Now, she said to Peggy, look at the picture. In your picture, I'm able to see your face. And in my picture, I'm able to see mine. That is Maddie's face. And in Peggy's picture, drawing, she's able to see the Peggy's face. Okay.